In this BorderConnect tutorial, I'll show you how to make changes and correct an ACI eManifest in BorderConnect. With an ACI eManifest, there are two main ways of changing or correcting information on an eManifest. The first involves making changes to the ACI eManifest, then sending a change request to CBSA. The other involves canceling the ACI eManifest, making the changes, and then resending the ACI eManifest to CBSA. In this tutorial, we'll cover both scenarios and the common types of changes that may need to be made. For a more in-depth guide on how to properly make changes to your ACI eManifest, you can visit BorderConnect Support Wiki at wiki.borderconnect.com. For the first part of this tutorial, we'll cover what elements of an ACI eManifest and shipment need a change request as opposed to a cancellation from an ACI eManifest that's already on file. So now, let's get started. Once you're logged in, navigate to the ACI eManifest menu option and click Search ACI eManifests, and click into the ACI eManifest you'd like to make changes to. Once you're in the ACI eManifest, you'll notice that the ACI eManifest is currently at three blue bars and on file with CBSA. The following items that can be changed without sending a cancel first are as follows: the port, the ETA, the truck, trailer, seals, and even cargo exemptions assigned to your ACI eManifest. For example, if you wanted to change your truck and trailer, scroll down first to the truck section, and on the right-hand side, hover over the three dots and click Remove. Then, quick assign or create your new truck and add it to the ACI eManifest. Perfect, now it's assigned. Next, repeat the process for the trailer. So go down below to the trailer section and remove the trailer. Then, quick assign or create the new trailer and assign it to the ACI. Great! Now your new truck and trailer are assigned to the manifest. Now it's time to let CBSA know of these changes that you made. To do this, go to the top of the page and under Send to CBSA, click Change Trip Only. The reason a change trip only needs to be transmitted is because you're only changing information related to the trip and not the shipment as well. However, if you were making changes to the shipment, you would need to send a change, trip, and shipments. So once you transmit the change trip only, you'll get a response back in about 1 to 2 minutes, indicating that your change request has been accepted and CBSA now has your updated information. Now we'll take a look at the information in a shipment that could be changed. So scroll down and click into the shipment on your ACI eManifest. Once you're in the ACI shipment details page, the information that can be changed without sending a cancel first are as follows: the shipment type, shipper, consignee, and anything related to the shipment commodity. So let's change the consignee and commodity details. First, you can remove the consignee by hovering over the three dots on the right-hand side of the consignee section and click Remove. Now use the Quick Assign feature to create a new consignee or to assign it to the shipment. Perfect! Now it's assigned to the shipment. Next, below, click into the commodity. Now you're on the commodity details page, so change your quantity and weight. Then, click Save. Now you can see that your commodity information has been changed as well. Now that the shipment information has been updated, it's time to let CBSA know of these changes. So, if you're only making changes to the shipment, scroll up to the top of the page, and under Send to CBSA, select Send Change Shipment Request. And in about 1 to 2 minutes, CBSA will accept your change request, and your new information is now on file with CBSA. For the next part of this tutorial, we'll focus on what information on your ACI eManifest and shipment need to be canceled first before making changes and resending to CBSA. So let's go back to the ACI eManifest details page. Changes that require your ACI eManifest to be canceled first are as follows: changing your trip number, adding or removing a shipment, or changing the shipment's cargo control number. For example, if you wanted to change the trip number on your already accepted ACI eManifest, you must send a cancellation first. So let's do that. Navigate to the top of your ACI eManifest, and under Send to CBSA, click Cancel Trip and Shipments. In about 1 to 2 minutes, CBSA will acknowledge your cancellation, and your ACI eManifest and shipment will turn to one red bar, Canceled. Now you're free to change your trip number. So on the top left, click Edit. Then, change your trip number and click Save. Now go back up to the top and under Send to CBSA, click Send Trip and Shipments. And in approximately 1 to 2 minutes, your ACI eManifest and shipment will turn to three blue bars, and the ACI eManifest is now accepted with the new trip number. Next, we'll cover what needs to be canceled on your ACI shipment. So scroll down and click into the shipment. Once on the ACI shipment details page, the only item that needs a cancellation is the cargo control number. So since the eManifest and shipment is already on file, the easiest way to change the cargo control number is to go back to the ACI eManifest, and at the top, under Send to CBSA, click Cancel Trip and Shipments. Once the ACI eManifest and shipment are at one red bar, Canceled Status, scroll back down to the shipment, and on the right-hand side of the Shipment section, hover over the three dots and click Edit. Here you'll be brought to the Edit ACI Shipment page, where you're free to change the cargo control number. Once done, click Save. Now go back to the ACI eManifest, and at the top of the page under Send to CBSA, click Send Trip and Shipments, only this time with your new cargo control number. And in about 1 to 2 minutes, CBSA will accept your ACI eManifest and shipment, and the status of both will change to three blue bars. And that's it. That's how you change your cargo control number and resend it to CBSA. Sending cancel requests are also required when adding or removing shipments from your ACI eManifest. For example, in this eManifest with three shipments, you learn that you have to remove a shipment from this already accepted ACI eManifest. To remove it, first go to the top of the eManifest and under Send to CBSA, click Cancel Trip and Shipments. And once the ACI eManifest and shipments are all at one red bar, canceled, scroll down and hover over the three dots on the right side of the shipment you'd like to remove, and then select Detach to remove it from the manifest. Now, if everything's correct, scroll back up to the top of the eManifest and under Send to CBSA, click Send Trip and Shipments. In about 2 minutes, CBSA will accept your eManifest, only this time with only two shipments instead of the original three shipments. The same procedure is true if you wanted to add an additional shipment to your ACI eManifest. For example, to add or create a new shipment, first go to the top of your already accepted ACI eManifest and under Send to CBSA, click Cancel Trip and Shipments. Once canceled, scroll down and click the button Create New Shipment. Add all the shipment details, and once you're back on the ACI eManifest Details page, you can see that the additional shipment has been created on your manifest. So now it's time to let CBSA know of this new shipment on your manifest. So scroll back up to the top, and under Send to CBSA, click Send Trip and Shipments. And in about 1 to 2 minutes, CBSA will accept your ACI eManifest with the additional shipment as well.
Hi, I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. Subscribe below for more videos like this, or sign up to BorderConnect for a free 45-day trial using special promo code EASY45. Thanks for watching.